Hello, I'm Mr. R. Niger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm giving deliberation on the ecclesiastical history by Eusebius. And he, St. James the Just, answered with a loud voice, "Why do ye ask me concerning Jesus, the Son of Man? He himself sitteth in heaven at the right hand of the great power, and is about to come upon the clouds of heaven." So he teased them, you know, that he is the Christ. And when many were fully convinced and glorified in the testimony of James, and said, "Hosanna to the Son of David," he was not Son of David, you know. But the Jewish people, they put it same. He was in line of David, but not Son of David. His father was God. The same scribes and Pharisees said again to one another. They were clever, you know. "We have done badly in supplying such testimony to Jesus. But let us go up and throw him down, in order that they may be afraid to believe in him." And they cried out, saying, Oh, the just man is also in error." And they fulfilled the scripture written in Isaiah. So they fulfilled the scripture, because these Pharisees, Sadducees, they planned this one, you know, and that's so they were telling people. So then let us take away. The just man, because he is troublesome to us. Therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their doings. That's a very good, you know. Anybody who is just in society and who is outspoken, you can today see also, the people want that he should be killed, you know, because he's exposing us. So these Pharisees, Sadducees also wanted to see that he is a troublesome man, because he speaks the truth. And the people, you know, will kill him. Therefore, they shall eat the fruit of their doings. So they killed a just man. So what is left behind will be the crook men. So they killed the just man, and then they followed those crook rabbis and Pharisees and Sadducees. And they eat the fruit of their doings. So they hated the just, loved the crook. So that's what they were doing. So they went up and threw down the just man and said to each other, "Let us stone James the Just." And they began to stone him, for he was not killed by the fall. But he turned and knelt down and said, "I entreat thee, Lord God, our Father, forgive them, for they know not what they are doing." So this was every apostle, every saint did, you know, because these people who stone them, they are fanatic, once born fanatic. They don't know what they are doing, and they are forgivable. People who do the thing knowingly, they are not forgiven. And while they were thus stoning him, one of the priests of the sons of Rechab, the son of the Rechabites, I don't know what they are, which is simply reproduction in Greek letters of the Hebrew plural, and is equivalent to the Rechabites. So they are Rechabites, mean the people of the tribe or Rechabite. So he came forward and who are mentioned by Jeremiah, the prophet, the Rechabite are mentioned there, cried out, saying, "Seize what do ye, the just one praying for you. So somebody came, you know, he said, oh, look, he is praying for you. And you are beating him, you are stoning him. I think that was Saul, you know, who cried out. And one of them, who was a fuller, took the club with which he beat out clothes and struck the just man on the head. And thus he suffered martyrdom. So they killed him by hitting this man, hitting with the club, you know. And he died and breathed his last. And they buried him on the spot by the temple. And his monument still remains by the temple. So his temple is a monument is still there of Saint James the Just. So just people will be killed, you know, because the people don't like to speak, hear the truth. So when I speak this truth, you know, which is unbiased and just, people hate me. That you can see on the remarks. People of the India hate me very greatly because they are supposed to be more fanatic than the people of the West. That's why Jesus said the lightning strikes in the East. It doesn't flash toward in the East, but flashes towards the West. It is appreciated in the West, not in the East. He became a true witness both to Jews and Greeks that Jesus is the Christ. And immediately Vesapion besieged them. So these things are related at length by Hegesippus, who is in agreement with Clement. So they are historian, you know, and other thing. James was so admirable a man and so celebrated among all for his justice, that the more sensible even of the Jews were of the opinion that this was the cause of the siege of Jerusalem, which happened to them immediately after his martyrdom, for no other reason than their daring act against him. So remember this siege, he was killed in 62 AD, then in 64 AD, all the just men from the Jerusalem, they left. And they were thinking that something will happen. So after they have left, then after 2 years after that, that means in 66 AD, the temple, Jerusalem was sieged and the temple was destroyed in 70 AD. Same, I think, is a prediction could be applicable to what's happening in this world today. In the first strike of this Satan was this Iraq war. Iraq has been demolished, you know, for no weapons of mass destruction found, but the money makes the mayor go to protect Israel. They destroyed Iraq, not for oil. Now there should be a second strike after end of this year, 2010 December. Then 2 years would be left to the Mayan calendar touching zero. That would be 2012. So we can expect another attack on the country which is making atomic bomb. And so after they attacked that one, then there will be 2 years of real tribulation. And then in 2012 could be atomic war, but God knows better than man. The spirit of man knows the things of men, but the spirit of God knows the things of God. So we are stupid. Our wisdom is stupid to that of our Father. But still, being in spirit, we proclaim or we give warning to the people to return to Christ Jesus. God bless.